live from Studio 6B in the Fimple Jamont Recreational Center for the Fashionably Exasperated, it's Pran Funkels Live. And now, join us for lots of prank phone calls.
Pran Funkels.
Aloha.
I don't know why, but it seems like it's been a month since we did a show. Does it feel like that, Garrett?
No.
Well, it's certainly been an amount of time since a certain individual was on the show. It's been a while.
Who is this, Chris?
You know what I'm talking about, Kira?
Mm-hmm. Is he gonna come forward?
Well, I think I have at contestant three. Would you like to turn over your cards and pull up your pants, do a little dance, and step forward? Mitch can.
My name is Bill.
Oh, okay. Ladies and gentlemen, Bill is on the show.
I'm gonna have my chicken.
Put that bird.
Just kidding, it's Mike.
This is Mike.
Hello.
Hello.
How's it going?
I'm doing pretty good. How are you doing?
Good. Doing well.
Welcome back. Your dreams were your ticket out.
Do you feel tickled?
Tickled pink.
Ooh, that's my favorite way to be tickled.
Let's party!
That fits well with our video that's going on our YouTube channel right now. That scrolling in your...
So, Mike, you've been following the shit. You know what this is, right?
Yeah. A little bit.
You kind of know about the call that this is based on?
I'm enjoying this.
You got it on full screen on your television?
Yes. It's pretty impressive.
So, we have Grandpa there, and then we have the three fellas in the back. That's Bill Hader. No, wait, I'm sorry. It's Al Pacino, Bill Hader, and Don Knotts.
Look at the feed right now.
Oh, okay. Hang on. Do you have an animation going?
Yes.
I was gonna say I'm not.
Oh shit! I was looking at the wrong fucking.
Yeah. Okay, no, well, this is different.
Yeah, this is quite different.
All right, play the music again.
Okay. Here.
Let's party!
Well, what was I talking about? Something else? Did we use that avatar that I was describing, Kira?
It was on there earlier.
Yeah, I'll stop this for a second, and this is what this is what Cody's talking about.
Have we used that yet?
No, it's a new one.
Oh, we're just showing this for now.
Yeah, I might there. Alternate it.
Okay, there we go. There's the fellas, and it's a...
Did Mike ever hear the Devin calls?
Devins, yes.
The
Noel.
The plumber.
I think I've heard one. I don't know if I've heard multiple.
Yeah. Did you hear the call where he drove to a gas station to meet up with us?
Yes. Okay. Yeah, that's the one I did hear.
That's what this is. Kira can describe it better than I can. Or is that? Do we need to do that now, Kira? Or?
Yeah, it's So like during the Devin calls, he kept saying, "Oh, I can't wait to show you this recording of the conversation I had with," he's talking about Grandpa.
Was it a voicemail we left, or he recorded? Oh, see, he recorded the call, yeah. Supposedly.
He supposedly records every first call he gets from a client, which is, by the way, illegal in California, where he is, without consent. But he kept saying, or at least once he said, "I want to show you this recording of this phone call." And he said, "Hot and horny guys," and it's like, "I'm not kidding, you gotta look at it." So that's Grandpa physically.
Look at this recording.
Yeah, he's looking at the recording, and everybody's presumably hot and horny guys coming out of the speaker or something. And that's what that is.
Isn't it like he's at a gas station and showing some other workers? There were a lot of factors that went into this, I think. Because he had, supposedly other workers that met him at the gas station, and they were all, hanging out, looking for a Honda Accord. Or...
in the middle of the night.
Well, I said that our house had a Honda Accord, a gold Honda Accord. Kira?
I thought he was going to walk up to the house there for a minute. I know there for a minute when he looking at a house and describing the house or the car or something. And
I think we tried to discourage that.
Yeah, I know it got kind of close there for a second. It could have went either way.
Yeah.
He seems pretty unstable.
And then I think a week or two ago we got another guy that was, it wasn't a plumber. Kira, do you remember that?
Yeah.
He was kind of similar, though. He's, desperate. He just wanted to be doing something. He was desperately trying to fulfill our needs.
I think he may have been that way because the week before, he, I think, decided to sleep through a call that we gave him.
And
I left him a message, "Hey, you have 24 hours in your business title, hello."
Oh, I forgot that's who it was.
I think...
Yeah, we called, several times and left a message, and then he texted us the next day and was like, "Oh, I just saw that you called that one time."
It's the call didn't come through, I'm sorry.
Yeah, your call didn't come through, even though, we called several times and it rang at least four times each and went to voicemail.
Yep. Okay, everybody, it's time for... Let me play the audio that goes with this.
Yes. There's audio that goes with the animation, folks.
Right.
I don't know if... All right.
Here we go.
"Now, honey, I have apple hack. What are we going to do about this? Come get you some apple hack, hon. You want some apple hack? Hack-o-pams? Nah, hack-o-pams, you didn't? See a baby and what you want? Hack-o-baby, huh? In a hand."
Oh my goodness.
I was hoping you'd play it twice, but we get the idea, I think. Did you enjoy that, Mike?
Yeah, that's very interesting.
Do I sound okay?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Does the apple cake lady sound okay?
Excellent.
Okay.
Is she going to be making a call tonight?
That's up to everyone else. I make no decisions on my own, as you know. I only rely on other people to do that. Because I'm a badass motherfucker. And a great leader. Not that I'm trying to lead anything right now. I'm just, you know. Kira, or is that on the itinerary?
I got mesmerized by that picture. For the video.
Patrick pointed out that the apple cake ladies, what did he say?
That her old lady tits turn into kids or something.
They morph into them.
And then when you play it backwards,
Mighty Morphin technology.
Yeah. But it's like you start kind of overhead-ish, and then you just go into this weird thing, and then you come out of it when it goes backwards, and it's like hell. You just go through it and come back, and you go through it and you come back. It's like a nightmare.
Just when you think you got out, they pull you right back in. Think a knocking about it.
Classic.
Was that quiet?
No. Should we make some calls?
I think so.
Mike, do you have Greg the Sea Captain? Because I have 4 Gregs to try.
I'm pretty sure I do. Let me look real quick.
And you can, like, open the call just saying, like, Greg or something.
Sorry if you heard me chewing chips.
Chewy, 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 puppy chow is chewy. Chewy morsels give the puppy good things to chew. Chewy, 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 puppy chow. Pocket to me, baby. With a
pocket to me, baby.
With a pocket to me, baby. With a
pocket to me, baby.
With a pocket to me, baby. With a
pocket to me, baby.
Who keeps throwing a block of ice at people who say, hock it to me, baby? Do you know what that was, Mike?
No.
There's the McDonald's wrapper. Did you hear it?
Yes, I did. Sorry, I was looking over the soundboard.
There's a thing with Mike's mic tonight where I think he's using the same hand he has a McDonald's Filet-O-Fish wrapper in to adjust his mic a lot.
Do I need to try to change headphones?
No, it's funny, actually. It just sounds like you're literally like you have a Filet-O-Fish right there.
Good morning, class!
Honey, don't you know I'm more than
I got a uterus and a vagina. I've got fully functioning female parts. I'm like a female Pac-Man.
Honey, don't you know I'm more than Pac-Man with a bow.
Ah, boy.
You guys are really whacked out.
Phyllis Diller, later, shall we?
Okay, let's call a bunch of Gregs. This is, Greg the Sad Loser, and he sounds like a certain person, if I can find it.
That's kind of the redundant to say Greg the Sad Loser, right? I mean, most Gregs, right?
He sounds like this.
I've got the worst cold a human being ever had. I've got a major presentation tomorrow. I've got a rest, and I'm out of NyQuil.
That reminds me of something.
Yeah?
I can tell it later. I don't know. It's a quick thing. I've been seeing ads for the new season of The Conners, which is, you know, Garfield minus Garfield. But Sean Astin is on it. And I guess these days he just looks like Nathan Lane, I've noticed.
Okay.
That's pretty weird. I had to actually look it up. I saw the ad and I was like, what was that, Sean Astin? And I had to look it up, the credits. But yeah. I mean, you know, not that there's anything wrong with looking like Nathan Lane, you know. Okay.
Your call has been forwarded to an automated voice messaging system. 5.
Good for you.
Goody for you.
Call him up.
The wireless customer you are calling is not available. Please try again later.
El cliente.
Hey, Ken. When and right home.
A bunch of these are old, so I don't know if they'll work. Like, these two.
Are they old Gregs?
That first one must have been.
I'm old Greg.
This is Liar Greg, who used the name Paul on the chat line.
This man's morals are all out of whack. They're really whacked out.
Apple.
Your call has been forwarded to an automated voice messaging system.
Captain Greg.
Greg, it's Tondrell.
Is not available.
Does he drive a Toyota Tundra?
I'm thinking he does.
Ah, sorry, we have to... Well, we'll just... That whole thing will... Yeah, okay, I'll shut up. It just looks like cake with apple slices sitting on it.
Your call has been forwarded to an automated voice messaging system.
Greg, it's Tondrell.
Is not available. At the tone, please record your message. When you've finished recording, you may hang up or press 1 for more options. To leave a callback number, press 5.
Eh. That was one hell of a preamble there for that beep. I thought that beep was never gonna happen. Well, we got some couple of business ideas for you, Greg. Charles was the one that sent me over a copy of what you did. I was pretty impressed.
Oh, after you put God, I guess there's two things. Thanks. Long after you put God, I guess there's two things.
Well, I hope you speak Charles. Because I don't. Anyway, give us a call back. ASAP, if you know what's good for you financially. You know what I mean?
If you're satisfied with the message, press 1. To listen to your message, press message review.
That's some good saxophone.
Man, that was one hell of a preamble there for that beep. I thought that beep was never going to happen. Well, we got some couple of business ideas for you, Greg. Charles was the one that sent me over a copy of what you did. I was pretty impressed.
After you put God, I guess there's two things. Thanks. Oh, after you for God. I guess there's two things.
Well, I hope you speak Charles. Because I don't.
Charles
anyway,
is having an orgasm.
Call back ASAP, if you know it's what's good for you financially. You know what I mean?
If you're satisfied with the message, press...
There's Glorious Greg.
Good for you. I got big lawyers.
You got Perry Mason?
Okay.
Matlock.
Your call has been forwarded to an automated voice messaging system.
Call him up.
Greg, it's time
call
for
him
us.
Up.
Okay, this guy was on the list twice with two different names, so let's call Greg the Nobody.
And that's where I am.
Your call has been forwarded to voicemail. The person you're trying to reach is not available. At the tone, please record your... Your call has been forwarded to voicemail. The person you're trying to reach is not...
Okay, that's it for Greg's.
Bye.
We called this person last week, and they didn't answer. They called us back twice outside of show hours and did not leave a message. But this is a note written on a napkin at a restaurant that says, PB and Jake. Sorry, there's stuff going on in the background here making me laugh. Okay, here we go.
Was this a note you found?
No, I just made up that story.
Oh, okay.
I wish I did.
The question mark was emphasized.
Please leave your...
Let's call Officer Boring.
Oh, that's a good one.
Could be.
The number you are trying to call has been disconnected.
No, it hasn't.
Stacey Hawking says it is.
Yeah, if you call Anonymous, it's supposedly disconnected, so.
That's too bad. It was an emergency. We were trying to get that $5 million to Officer Boring, but his number's disconnected.
The number you are trying to call has been disconnected.
I think he's blocked us on a bunch of lines. I'm not gonna pick through them, so let's go to... Okay, this one's not gonna answer, but listen closely, because you'll hear a guy... who definitely has a mouthful of potato salad.
Okay.
Thank you for calling government.com regarding our classic U.S. gold offer. Our office is currently closed. Our normal business hours are Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. to 7 p.m. Central Time, and Saturdays, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Central Time. Please leave your name and phone number, and one of our coin professionals will return your call on the next business day.
One of their
Thanks,
coin
and have a great day.
Professionals?
Hello.
You passed potato salad, honey.
Well, don't forget to get some apple cake on your way out when you're packing up your leftovers, hon. I've got some apple cake I made earlier today.
Now, honey, I'll have apple cake.
Get the Metamucil, honey.
Okay. Okay, is it in the cupboard?
It's up in the cupboard, hon.
Okay.
Sprinkle it on my cocaine and I'll snort it, hon.
To make private ejaculate, press 2.
What happened?
Are we adding to it, hon?
Thank you for leaving your message. To access your mailbox, press *R. To transfer to another extension, press *T.
Not
to reach
Jackie
the covering
Thomas.
Extension, press.
I
think Jackie sent all that to. Was that Officer Boring still?
No, it was the potato salad guy.
Oh, I'm sorry. I need to catch up mentally.
That's okay.
Mike, did you hear that guy with a potato salad in his mouth?
No, I did. That's definitely had something going on there.
Well, that goes.
Picturing with... I don't know about you. I was picturing with a mustache.
Yeah.
I think there was definitely some caught in it. I'd rather have potato salad caught in my mustache than be caught in a Turkish prison, though, you know?
That would be preferable, yes.
And it goes with my palate right now. I mean, I was eating some Utz fried pickle potato chips. I gotta say, thumbs up.
I've had those. They're good.
I think they're great.
I've heard positive things.
Have you heard about them?
I have. But I've never seen them.
I would recommend them. Do you like fried pickles?
I do.
Well, then you're going to like these. That's what they taste like.
Oh, the
They're
ones
great
I
for
got.
Dip,
they weren't. But they didn't say fried, they just said pickle chips.
Were they Utz?
Yeah.
Huh.
It was like a specific. Brand like Grillo's pickles, which I've also had because they sell both of those at Costco here.
Yeah, it must be a regional thing because I've never seen that here. I've just seen the fried pickle chips.
Okay, yeah, it looks very southern, so.
Yeah.
Here's a number.
I had some fried green tomatoes recently from a restaurant.
Did you?
That's here.
I don't think I've seen that movie.
I saw it a long time ago.
Thumbs up or down?
I remember liking it.
Mm-hmm.
I saw commercials for it as a kid and was not interested in it at all. But I think I saw it as an adult and kind of enjoyed it. I mean, it's got Gaylord Sartain in it, so. It's got someone who Jack likes to stare at in a hot tub. Kathy Bates naked. No, that's a different movie. I'm just trying to, anyway. What are we doing?
Well, I didn't hear anything about the tits. How big are the tits?
Your audience stuttered.
Chris.
Well, I wish Chris was on tonight, but he's not able to be on, and we love him a lot. Or is he?
Yeah, he's not able to be on, but I want to thank him for everything that he did, the good time, and the soundboards that he made.
Yes, it was always good to be able to listen and hear some more soundboards coming up. When I wasn't able to be on the show, I do appreciate it. I liked hearing all the new stuff.
Yeah. Is that you on the keyboard, Kira?
Yes.
Okay. I could tell. You want to know why, or do I even need to explain it?
Why?
Because it sounded like someone attempting to play something, and 90-some percent of kids and adults who don't really know how to play an instrument just, like, bang away at it, you know?
Yeah.
Or they, like, hit the same note over and over 8 billion times, or they either do that or they just, like, hit just a menagerie of notes.
Yeah. You ever had the piano in your house and random people come over and just start playing it?
Yeah, and it's like there's almost no in-between. It's like they either play something that resembles a song, or they just bang around on it.
They pick up somebody's guitar.
Not cool, dude. Not cool.
Yeah, and in that case, Patrick knew how to play it, but it was not cool, apparently.
Because Tobe, or whoever, told him.
Yeah, it was not.
Not cool, man.
Toby.
I just being honest here, I think I was only ever at maybe one or two parties that he might have been at. But for the most part, I would avoid anything that he might be at. And not even because of him necessarily, I just, you know, it was just a natural thing, you know.
Yeah, damn.
I wouldn't want to be there for any other reason either, you know? Love you a lot, if you're listening. I'm pretty sure he doesn't.
We have a new new mesothelioma number. I don't know. What's that?
Oh, I'm doing that thing in the movies where you, like, accidentally conjure up a spirit that you don't want to. So I'm gonna stop doing that right now. We don't want. No, I'll shut up. Don't. If you're out there, Toby, we don't want to hear from you in any manner whatsoever.
Come on.
Other than soundboard. Or, you know, if we call you, we'd like for you to speak, but we know that's not gonna happen. Okay.
A new mesothelioma number. So, we're playing this game every time I get this where we say, is it the free book guy? Here we go.
Thanks for calling. Our offices are currently closed. Please call us back between 9 a.m. and 5 p.m. Central Standard Time. Thank you.
Do you have that clip of the free book guy opening his coffin?
No.
Ah, you played it not too long ago.
I did?
Yeah. It sounded a lot like when you press start on a certain game. Ah, we don't have to do that.
I'm not following. I'm too gone to follow it, what you're saying.
I can impersonate it.
Okay.
You hear me do that?
Okay.
Okay.
Oh, is it Dracula X?
No, it's the free book guy waking up. I'm sorry, that was just him weed eating.
Okay.
My weeds are getting too tall.
Do you have... Mike, do you have a easily offended lady for a water or fire damage place?
Yes.
Now that's damage with a capital E in the middle of it.
Okay. Let's change the avatar back to Grandpa.
Look at this recording, fellas.
The one guy is, like, coming out of the windshield.
Yes, I think me and Here for the Comments noticed that.
Yeah.
There's Toby.
Okay. Is somebody we called ready?
Yes. Who? Soundboard?
Hello?
Hello?
This is Garrett Canada. Did you call me? I'm returning your call.
Yeah. Who's this?
Oh, my name is Garrett. I had a call from you. Did you call me?
What's up, buddy?
No?
I ain't talking to nobody, buddy.
Oh, sorry. My mistake.
Hey, you called me?
I have.
No, I just called, but somebody called me from your number.
Honey, I called him about...
No worries. That's okay. Bye-bye. Good night.
No, I did call. I called you for your service, hon. Are you still there?
Oh, God damn it. That guy sounded like he had not apple cake, but potato salad in his mouth, too.
Let's call him back.
He's definitely eating something.
It's about to be Crow.
It's Little Debbie something.
Please leave your message for 808.
You call my number.
Eh?
You call my fucking number? What you call my number for?
Sure.
My wife's all upset.
Sure.
You woke my wife up, you call my fucking number. It's 1:40 in the fucking morning. You call my fucking wife?
You don't need to talk to me like that. I don't deserve it.
You call my wife up, you cursing? I want to know why you call my fucking number. You call my fucking number? You call it?
To replay your message, press 1. To
You call my number.
Eh?
You call my fucking number. What do you call my number for?
Sure.
My wife's all upset. You woke my wife up. You call my fucking number. It's 1:40 in the fucking morning. You call my fucking wife.
You don't need to talk to me like that. I don't deserve it.
You call my wife up. You cursing. I want to know why you call my fucking number. You call my fucking number? You call it?
To replay your message.
I think that was a good message. I was thinking that might be good to just go about a call like that. Well, I'll just do that. Except, you know, talking to someone. Kind of like
keep accusing them.
Yeah, I mean, we've heard it work with soundboards countless times.
Right.
Like, it just riles them up when you accuse them of calling us. Hey, you want to make a call?
Yeah.
So, how many people have answered tonight? Just one so far?
Something like that.
Nah. Dick pics. Alright, you want to call an electric company that Morgan Freeman works at?
Yeah.
Do you know what that reference is about?
Morgan Freeman works at... No.
It was an educational program on PBS that... He was on that. Back in the 70s or...
Have we played it on the show before?
Maybe. I don't know. I know that Patrick and I watched it. Patrick more than me, because I just barely remember seeing it. But they showed it on TV Land for a while in the mid-90s. Or, you know, when that channel was new. TV Land was like... Do you know what it was? Do you remember it?
TV Land?
Yeah, well, it's probably still around, but it's not doing what it was set out to do.
Yeah.
That's funny, because TV Land was an offshoot of Nick at Night, and it was like...
Okay.
It was like MTV. People were bitching that they didn't show music videos, and that they made MTV2 just for music videos, and then they started showing bullshit reality on that very quickly. And TV Land was the same thing. Like, it lasted longer, I think, but then they were like, we have original programming now. Like, oh, okay, well, that's the opposite of why this channel was created. But, yeah,
I think it's probably still around, but I don't know for sure.
But yeah, I think they were doing pretty well at having shows that they did, but, you know, I don't know. The times, they are a-changing, man.
Yeah, you could say that.
You gotta change with them, man. You know what never changes? Until a certain device becomes obsolete? Prank calling.
Uh-huh.
Alright, we're gonna call an electric company.
Gumpany?
A subscriber you have dialed is not in service. If you feel you've received...
That guy has some liquid smoke in his mouth. Well, I needed some, there's a 24-hour service for you. They have a U.S. Sprint phone, apparently. They didn't pay the bill on. Let's go to the next one in the list.
Unavailable.
You want to do this?
I made the donkey kind.
Yes.
Thank you for calling Mr. Electric. Please press 1 if you are a customer. Select 2 if this is a sales or telemarketing call. Press 3 if you are one of our suppliers.
I'm an air supplier. All out of love.
Thank you for calling Mr. Electric. Someone will be with you in just a moment.
For quality assurance, your call is now being recorded.
It's a great day at Mr. Electric. This is Fritzy. How can I help you?
Hey, guys, you're doing a great job. You have improved my lifestyle.
How can I help you?
It was obvious right off the bat that everyone care, that everyone's a big family.
Just give us a call back.
Can you hear me? I'm here. Hello.
What can I say?
Gonna give him a call back?
Well, she is.
I think she actually couldn't hear us.
Thank you for calling the Best Western Company.
I swear to God, I set the audio settings properly.
Thank you for calling the Best Western
Company. Uh-oh. They heard me talking.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, I guess I'll have to call them back.
Thank you for calling Mr. Electric. Please press 1 if you are a customer. Select...
Thank you for calling Mr. Electric. Someone will be with you in just a moment.
For quality assurance, your call is now being recorded.
It's a great day at Mr. Electric. This is Jim. How can I help you?
Hello? Hello, I'm here.
Oh, there you are. Okay. I must... How can I help you?
Could you put your husband on the line?
My husband?
I want to talk to your husband for a minute. May I speak to him, please?
I think you have the wrong number.
Put your husband on the phone.
I don't have a husband, sir.
Sir? Can you put your husband on the line?
Sir, I don't have a husband. I have a wife.
Your husband's at a motel.
You've got the wrong number, sir.
I'm the desk clerk at your hotel. This is Bert.
This is not a hotel.
Why are you upset?
This is Mr. Electric. I'm the answering service.
Could you let me talk, please? You have no idea who I am, so how do you know that I've been doing your husband at a motel?
Because I don't have a husband.
Please? Can you give me drugs, please?
Goodbye.
Your brother, I want to talk to him. Put him on the phone. Give him your drugs. So I want you to give him the drugs now.
That was a good response.
Well, shit.
You want to call him back or move on?
You can move on.
How's that Filet-O-Fish treating you? I hope it's not beating the shit out of you because you didn't do the dishes properly.
No.
Are you still opening it? I hear that crinkling.
Thank you for calling the Best Western Hospitality. This is Bert.
Sorry about that, man.
Did you bump it with your Filet-O-Fish accidentally?
My fish fillet fell on it. It did. Well, shit.
Well, that was a good one.
Yeah, it worked out all right.
I think I heard the beginning of Jungle Love there by Steve Miller.
Is that what that was?
Well, I heard some... I met you in northern Iowa. Not to be confused with Wero by Beck. I should probably stop whistling.
Your call has been forwarded to voicemail. The person you're trying to reach is not available. At the tone, please record your message. When you have finished recording, you may hang up.
Pimplement Service has a message for you from Claire. Go ahead, Claire.
It's comforting to know that they can provide me with both a better colostomy device and a better catheter. Through their great sampling program, I was definitely given a better catheter.
Al, if you'd like your free ice cream coupon, give us a call back at 402-882-2083.
Man, it's like I jumped into another century. Originally, when I got out of the hospital, I used a straight-tip catheter and some Surgilube in my butt.
Just jumped into a different Buick Century.
Attaboy.
I did a pattern on the keypad there. If any of our autistic people are listening, I'm sure you're already aware of that. Just from the sounds.
It's good to know.
Alright, let's try a different number. Have you visited Tom?
A little bit. I have.
Nope.
Have you?
Yes.
I did. I heard something.
Okay.
Faintly.
All right, let's make another call.
Turn that off!
Let's make a call.
We're sorry, you have reached a number that has been disconnected or is no longer in service.
Calls may be recorded. Please enter the zip code where you need an electrician.
199.
Please enter the zip code where you need an electrician.
280.
Please hold while we connect your call to a local electrician.
Please enter the 5-digit zip code for the area in which you need service. This call may be recorded and/or monitored for quality assurance purposes.
To serve you better, this call may be...
This call may be hung up as soon as we decide we don't want to do our jobs.
Did they tell us, like, what, 3 times that the phone call would be recorded?
For quality purposes, to make sure we hang up on you at the right moment after you've waited long enough, we're going to record this fucking call. I like how they throw it out as a fucking threat.
Calls may be recorded. Please enter the zip code where you need an electrician.
Hang it up!
Sorry.
Oh, I know you are sorry.
Sorry that I fucked that up.
No, it's just...
Please enter the zip code where you need an electrician.
And confuse her.
By entering numbers.
Please hold while we connect your call to a local electrician.
This call will be recorded for quality assurance. Thank you for calling. Please press 1 to continue. Thank you for calling.
Thank you for calling Delta Electrical Solutions. We are unable to come to the phone at the moment.
24-hour service, ladies and gentlemen.
Number, the reason for your call, and we'll be sure to get back with you. Thank you.
And the reason for my call is I thought this was a 24-hour service.
When you've finished recording, you may hang up or press 1 for more options.
Incoming call.
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, go.
Hello.
Hello. Yeah.
I interrupted you.
Yeah, I just got a missed call from you.
Oh, is there someone there? Are you calling about?
We'll be right back.
97.8 Cool FM. We play the coolest music.
That was the J-O-I lady. And let's call Mike's away. Cody will be back. I need to get a soundboard up. Okay. And call this place.
Thank you for calling ServPro. We are always here to help. Please listen closely as our menu options have changed. All calls may be recorded for quality and training purposes.
Para español, presione 9.
If you previously called the National Call Center, press 1 to enter your phone number or reference number. For a commercial structure, press 2. For a residential structure, press 3. If you have a customer concern, press 4. For franchise opportunities, press 5. For all other requests or questions, press 7. To hear these options again, press 8. Your call is being transferred to the next available agent.
If you would like to continue to hold, please stay on the line and your call will be answered in the order it was received. If you do not wish to continue to hold and would like to fill out your information via our online service request form, please visit servpro.com/help. If you are in an area affected by the recent freeze event, rest assured that we are bringing additional crews into your area to get you the help you need just as quickly as possible.
You are the next caller in the queue.
Thank you for calling ServPro. We're always here to help. This is Andy. How may I help you?
Hello?
Hello?
Water damage?
Do you have some water damage?
Yes.
Okay. I just need to get some information from you, and then I can contact that local franchise for you, okay?
Okay.
May I have your first and last name, please?
Chris DeHart.
Spell your last name for me, please.
Chris, C-H-R-I-S.
Uh-huh.
DeHart.
And what's the spelling of your last name?
Okay.
What's the spelling of your last name?
DeHart.
What's the spelling, please?
Is there something I can help you with?
Well, she was all business. Mike, do you want to call her back with easily offended lady?
Yeah, you can try.
Okay.
I don't know if I'll get past that part, but see if we can throw her off with something.
Thank you for calling ServPro. We are always here to help. Please listen closely as our menu options have changed. All calls may be recorded for quality and training purposes.
Para español, presione 9.
If you previously called, your call is being transferred to the next available agent.
If you would like to continue to hold, please stay on the line and your call will be answered in the order it was received. If you do not wish to continue to hold and would like to fill out your information via our online service request form, please visit servpro.com/help. If you are in an area affected by the recent freeze event, rest assured that we are bringing additional crews into your area to get you the help you need just as quickly as possible.
Thank you for choosing ServPro. We're always here to help. This is Kayla. How may I assist you?
Hello?
Thank you for choosing ServPro. We're always here to help. This is Kayla. How may I assist you?
Water damage?
Okay. Okay. Well, you've reached our call center. I can take your information and get it to a local franchise and have them give you a call.
Okay.
And what is your name?
This is Chris.
And last name?
Dee Hart.
And what is a good phone number for a callback?
I'm sorry. I just answered my phone, and now it happened to you.
402-882-2083. Okay, so that was 402-882-2083.
Yes.
Is that a cell phone where you authorize a text message to be sent to?
Yes.
Okay, and is there a secondary phone number email you'd like to add as a backup?
No.
Okay. All right, and just confirming, you'll be the point of contact when reaching out to that number, correct?
Yes.
Okay, and what is the address where service is needed?
Technicians.
I'm sorry, is this a residential property or commercial?
That's what I'm saying.
I'm sorry, I'm having a really hard time hearing you. Is this a commercial property?
I believe you're totally right.
You said it was Jack Newsom?
Yes.
Okay. All right, and what is the street address?
Okay,
Oh, ma'am, were you speaking with my grandma?
Yes.
Okay, and you need the address, is that right?
Yes, I would need the address so we can get the information to the closest franchise.
Oh, we need somebody out tonight.
Oh, we would get it over to them, and their on-call technician would reach out to you within the hour or less.
Okay, it's 423... Wonder Lane.
Hey, and is this a, sorry, what is the zip code?
92111.
All right. And, is this a residential property or commercial?
It's residential. I'm gonna have you talk to my grandma again.
Okay. Okay.
No problem.
And did the water damage, did it just happen?
Yes.
Okay. And what was it that caused it? Did a toilet leak or a pipe break?
That happened to me one night. I answered the phone because she thought I was calling her, and I water damage? Must be a mistake. Fire damage.
Oh, no, Grandma, it's water damage, remember?
No. For heaven's sakes.
We have a bidet that's on the fritz.
Okay, and is there standing water?
There is, yeah, it's getting worse by the moment.
Okay.
So.
Okay. All right, just a couple more questions that I'm required to ask. What type of flooring is in the area affected?
It's tile.
Tile, okay.
May I place you on a brief hold, ma'am?
Yeah.
Thank you. Okay, Grandma, go ahead.
I don't know. I think it must be a glitch in the system somehow. Hello?
Yes, I'm here. I just had a couple more questions that I need to ask you. Do you know if you will try and file a homeowner's claim for this, or would you just self-pay? I can put unknown here if you don't know.
Ma'am?
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. All right, and just let me verify that address with you. Was that 423 Wonder Lane?
Yes.
Okay, in San Diego?
Yes, California.
Okay. All right. All right, and then last question I'm just required to ask is how you heard about us. Did you find us online, or did you hear about us another way?
Okay. Same here.
All right. Well, we will go ahead and get this over to the local franchise. Their on-call technician should reach out to you within the hour or less. And I do have a reference number here if you would like that.
Okay.
Your reference number is 369. Honey, don't you know I'm more than Pac-Man
with a bow? Honey. Thank you very much.
Of course, thank you for choosing ServPro. Have a good night.
Okay.
So the on-call technician with the local franchise will be giving you a call within the hour or less.
Okay.
All right. Well, thank you for choosing ServPro. Have a good one.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Well, she was kind.
Yeah, that was fun. It was just ended up being a normal call, and now hopefully we'll get an incoming Pran Funkel. let's call a lawsuit for Camp Lejeune. These things are plentiful. Okay.
Thank you for calling our law office. We'll be on the line shortly to help you. Please stay on the line. Your estimated wait time is less than 60 seconds. We're up.
Thank you for calling. All calls will be recorded for quality assurance purposes. A live team member will be with you momentarily.
Thank you for calling about the Camp Lejeune toxic water lawsuit. This is Nydia. Are you calling about a potential new case, returning one of our calls, or have you signed an agreement with our firm already?
Yes.
Hello.
Hello?
Hello? Hi, yes, hello? You're calling for a new case?
I've been getting too many calls from private numbers.
I'm sorry, ma'am.
The private number.
Okay, ma'am. This is hello? The Camp Lejeune toxic water lawsuit. Can you hear me?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Are you calling? Okay. Are you calling about a potential new case?
Yes.
Okay. May I please have your first name?
Please.
I'm sorry.
My name is Carolyn.
Okay. I can barely understand you, ma'am. Is this the best number to call you right back?
Yes.
Ma'am? Okay.
Please?
I can barely understand you, ma'am. Let me call you right back, see if I can hear you much better, okay?
Okay. Okay, baby.
Okay. Thank you.
You have a good afternoon.
Do I need to turn down some?
That sounds fine to me. Okay, here we go.
I have a call coming in. Hello?
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 Okay, ma'am. I can hear you a little bit much better. Okay, can you...
Here we go again.
Oh, can you hear me?
Yes. Woo!
Okay. May I have the spelling of your first name?
I'm not no bitch.
I'm sorry?
First of all, my name is Carolyn.
Okay, may I have the spelling, please?
Nope.
I'm sorry, may I have the spelling of your first name? Eric?
Carolyn.
Okay, ma'am. May I have the spelling, please?
This is a private number.
May I have the spelling of your first name?
Oh, her name is Karen.
Really?
Okay, that was Karen of November?
Yes.
Thank you. And your last name, please?
No, what?
May I have your last name?
Mississippi.
Ma'am? Okay. Your last name is Mississippi?
Yes.
Okay. Bear with me a moment. And, of course, that's M as a Mike, I, S as Sierra, S as Sierra, I, S as Sierra, S as Sierra, I, P as in Papa, P as in Papa, I?
Oh, yes.
I'm sorry?
Tell them what's going on.
Okay, and this is the best number to reach you, right? The... Okay. Did you or a loved one live or work on a base at Camp Lejeune for at least 30 days between August 1st, 1953 and December
31st, 1987?
Yes.
Okay. Do you have one?
I'm sorry?
I know my name.
Ma'am. I'm going to go ahead and repeat the question. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yes, you can hear me?
Yes. You know?
Okay.
Okay, baby.
Okay, I'm going to go ahead. Okay, ma'am. I'm going to go ahead and place you on a brief hold. Oh, one moment, please, okay?
I'm not stupid.
I'm sorry?
I'm not stupid. You are a damn lie, bitch.
Ma'am, can you please refrain your language? I want to place you on a brief hold. One moment, please.
First of all, I don't work. I almost didn't answer it.
Okay, ma'am. I'm going to place you on a phone.
Don't worry. I'm unemployed.
Okay.
bothered because I have been receiving calls.
Thank you for holding. My name is Yahida, and I am the supervisor. How may I help you tonight?
Hell to the no!
I'm sorry?
You called me from a private number.
How can I help you tonight?
I've been getting too many calls from private numbers.
Okay, this is Camp Lejeune.
You calling from a private number.
Okay, thank you so much for calling. Have a good night.
You called my fucking call. I ain't call yours.
Examine your makeup carefully and something to keep the hair off your forehead so you don't get the makeup into your hair. Sometimes a little headband like this is good. I don't use one because my head is so big and they tend to break. Sometimes just an old ball cap works good. Put it on backwards and it keeps the hair off the forehead. We also have some colors that need to go on. Colors come in a variety of forms. These are called lining sticks, and they're used for filling in some of the larger areas or putting on wide lines on your face. The same colors you'll find in little tubs like this. Some clowns like to put their makeup on with fingers, or in this case, they may use a brush. The kind of brush that I recommend is a sable brush. It draws a very neat line, and all you need to do is touch this into some oil, wipe off the excess, brush it back and forth, and you can do some rather intricate lining. I think that most clowns only need perhaps one beginning brush, which I'd recommend about a quarter of an inch. Along with this, we need to set the makeup. When we say set the makeup, it means putting some talcum powder on so that when you're done, your face is totally dry. You can wipe your fingers across it and no makeup will come off. Beginners like myself appreciate using just a child's cotton stocking, and I fill it with talcum powder, and as you pat your face, you'll notice a nice even coat of powder comes off. And that is impregnated into the makeup and sets it nicely. Some clowns like to put their powder on with a lamb's wool puff. This is a very nice one. What they do is you scoop the powder and you literally throw it on your face as you pat it lightly, and then you're able to take the softness and brush off the excess powder. Another way to brush off the excess powder is through the use of a shaving brush or a children's hairbrush. I happen to use both, one for the reds and one for the whites. You can also buy just a simple powder brush at almost any makeup store. Sometimes when we're thinking about our makeup, we get a little bit of concern about our nose. Noses can come in a variety of shapes, and they're available in all kinds of stores. The one that I choose to use, I put on with just some simple elastic string that I buy in a notions store. But there are other clowns who don't like to see that string that's visible, so they'll use a lightweight red rubber nose, and we'll put it on perhaps with spirit gum, or one of the things that works really well is some surgical tape that has a double sticky side. You put a little piece in on each side, clamp it on your nose, and it stays nicely. Remember, if you are going to use a rubber nose, you should clean your nose thoroughly. If you don't, the adhesive material won't stick too well. I have to clean mine with alcohol because I perspire quite profusely, and there's nothing more embarrassing than have your nose come sliding off. A real good alternative is to use no rubber nose at all. Simply draw on your nose, powder it nicely, and you'll never have to worry about losing your nose ever in any crowd. My makeup is fairly simple, but it will give you an idea not only of the white-faced makeup, but the same principles which will apply to any of the makeups. I like to start by putting just a few drops of moisturizer cream on my face. Make sure it's a very small amount. I use a theatrical pencil to outline my mouth. One of the things we ought to remember is that the outer edge of your mouth should at no time extend beyond a straight line from the outside corner of your eye. Once I'm satisfied, I begin the application of the white. One thing that really helps is if the makeup is at body temperature. When I make up in public, I sometimes carry my clown white in my pocket for about a half hour in advance, which brings it up to body temperature. When you put the white makeup on, you essentially want to get just enough to cover your skin so that the flesh tone of your skin does not show through in a dominant way. If you get it too thick, it is almost impossible to thin it down. Although you can put colors over the white, they're not quite as bright as if they go on the bare skin. So I put the white makeup around my mouth and bring it right up to the black line. When the white is on, take two or three fingers and begin patting it firmly. Don't just touch it, pat it. And as you do, you'll notice that the streaks of makeup begin to disappear. When I'm not making up in public, I like to dip my fingers into cold water and continue the patting. For me, I find it makes the makeup a bit more...
Hello.
Hello. Hello?
Yeah, can you hear me?
I can. Can you hear me?
Yes.
All right.
Did you have a call going?
No. Did not.
Well, what'd I miss?
I don't remember.
Did you get anybody to answer in there?
Yeah, I was talking to somebody, the Camp Lejeune lady, for a while. I was talking to
my name is Carolyn.
But she got hateful pretty quick, and they didn't like that. Passed me off to a manager, and then that didn't go very well either.
In a good way, or?
Nah, short and sweet.
Well, you want to call another number?
Certainly.
Certainly, sir.
Certainly, sir.
That is correct.
It says it's going. Jesus. Well, you know what time it is.
Hang up!
Okay. Got a problem. We can't hear the weekly word.
Yeah.
I think all all the settings are correct. Oh, yeah, we heard that.
So this was a Galder Bash device?
Hadn't heard that in a while.
That's nice and loud.
Yeah, that's a turned down version. And for what, you know?
What for?
Yeah, what for? What gives with the turning down?
Answer shit.
It's supposedly dialing. Alright, let's try this one again.
Ravington 4?
Yeah, we can sure as hell hear the hang-up noise.
Bleeper, 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 bleeper,
bleeper, bleeper. I thought that was you doing it at first, but I had to mute because my background noise was cutting you out there.
Hello. You do have a lot of background noise tonight.
Yeah, it's mainly the heater.
Yeah.
That sounded like a alien there.
They suggested the self-lubricating, the hydrophilic catheters.
Oh, yeah?
Right.
Okay.
Honestly,
maybe
I didn't know any better.
Let's try reloading
but,
the window.
But.
This is Oklahoma City weather now.
The time...
Now let's reload.
Originally, when I got out of the hospital, I used a straight tip catheter and some Surgilube. But
this is Oklahoma.
Did you make it say that?
No, that's what she said. You heard the lady.
Originally, when I got out of the hospital, I used a straight tip catheter and some Surgilube in my butt.
Well, that's
she had to figure. She tried. She was trying to figure things out.
Yeah, she was confused.
Wrong hold, WMV, honey.
Honestly, I didn't know any better.
Who's Imus Lee?
Honestly, I didn't know any better.
Hi, you've reached Rod Castle with Core Northwest.
Is this a joke?
Can be.
There we go. They hung up right before I was gonna. Alright, let's call this number. Back. Do you know what to use, Mike?
Water damage?
Yes. This is the number that called us, I think.
Thank you for calling ServPro. Calls may be recorded for quality and training purposes. Please stay on the line. Someone will be with you shortly.
Please stay on the line while your call is transferred to the operator.
What was that?
It's another Pran Funkels. Pick a hang up. Pick a hang up. Pick a hang up.
Bird ant. Rest in peace. Also, another Toby. R.I.P.
Thanks for calling MFA Oil and Propane. Our office hours are Monday through Friday.
Yeah, probably shouldn't say that you're 24 hours on Google then.
Come on.
Get ready to laugh, cause it's time for Pran Funkels Funnies.
Micah, what do you get when you cross a vampire and a snowman?
Frostbite.
Joke was, and we all got it, but I'm just gonna ask Mike to explain it to us right now. Mike, can you explain it to us right now?
Negative.
I'm gonna be real honest and just say, I'm not sure I got the joke. I'm not sure what was being said there.
No, it's not a no, it's a yes.
I turn back on the apple cake lady again.
What?
I turned the apple cake video back on for the avatar.
Yes.
Okay, let's call.
Apple.
Let's call the doorbell technician who really rings your bell.
was the joke that it...
The vampire joke?
What was that? What was the end part?
Your call has been forwarded to voicemail. The person you're trying to reach is not available. At the tone, please record your message. When you have finished recording, you may hang up.
That was a bit of a yinkle yankle.
Hello? Hello?
Hey. There's a batter. Did you leave it on the countertop?
What's that?
Robert. Who left that batter out? It dried up.
What are you talking about?
Oh, Mr. Simple's got your hinkle out.
You know, like for kids and stuff like that.
You can give him a call back?
Yes, sir.
You want somebody else to do it?
Hello?
Hi. You hung up on my boyfriend for some reason.
What is this about?
The dick pics.
It's Ron.
The what?
Dick pic. Let me have you talk.
Dick pics?
Let me have you talk to Ron. Here he is.
That's Ron.
You needed something?
Dick pics.
The what?
Dick pics. Is it like a candy or something? Dick pics? I don't know what it is.
I don't know. You tell me.
So I'm not hearing you.
You came up with the word.
We got dick pics.
Good for you, man.
Hello? Who are you talking to?
Idiot.
Hey, speak up. What? What did he say?
I think he said idiot.
Well, it's definitely not calling back.
My computer just froze.
Oh, God.
Shit.
Probably snorted too many dick pics. No offense. What was that?
It's another Pran Funkels.
Your call has been forwarded to voicemail.
Thanks, lady from Austin Powers, that I can never think of her name. Teacher lady loves you a lot.
Your call has been forwarded...
Well, shit.
Let's call a...
Business. Don't wait, or you'll miss what everyone is talking...
Thank you for calling Luminesce, home of the world's best makeup and skincare airbrush systems. To learn more about our exciting, risk-free trial offer,
And if you are ready to try the Luminesce Breeze in your home, please press 1.
Free of Ricks, please.
Thank you for calling Luminous. This is Tori. It's a pleasure to meet you. May I have your name, please?
Hey.
Hi. May I have your name?
Marduk. Josephs.
The LucasArts, not Harrison Ford.
Yes.
Hey, guys, you're doing a heck of a job.
Thank you for calling Luminesce, home of the world's best makeup and skincare airbrush systems. To learn
and
more about our
registered sex offenders. But we don't like to talk about that.
Hello?
Hi, thank you for calling Luminous. This is Tori. Nice to meet you. May I have your name?
Josephs.
And thank you for calling. It's a pleasure to meet you. This call is being recorded for quality purpose. I assume you're calling regarding our New Year, New You event, right?
Uh-huh.
All right. So what brings you into calling in today?
I think there's something over there I need. You want to help me find out?
Sure, and what is that?
What a choice.
Huh?
Verily, does my device raise man on high?
I still don't know what the fuck it... that... That is great for a soundboard, because, like, who knows what the fuck he's talking about? Is that from a movie?
It's from a computer game.
Well, yeah, but, like, what's the quote from? Is it from an Indiana Jones movie?
I don't know. Not that I recall.
Verily, does my... It just sent, like, a lot of those. It's like, I'm assuming it's when you, like, click on something and... tell it to do something that is absurd.
And it's that thing looks whippable. I might be able to whip that thing.
I like that one Whip It song that Devo did. You know that one song they ever did?
Yeah. They got together just to record that one song.
Teacher ladies. Getting older.
No!
It sounds like she's hanging out with Dracula or something there.
Maybe.
Symphony of the Night. I'm just sitting here talking. Wanna make a call?
Stoy!
Okay.
Thanks, Chris, for making that soundboard.
Yes, thank you. Mike is having issues.
Are you still on, Mike?
Yeah, it's fixed now. It was... something went wrong with the mirroring to my monitor.
Okay.
To my TV. It's good.
And like, we can hear some... we can hear ourselves feeding back from your monitor. Not that we're complaining, but your fillet of fish is ready. I think. Did you get it out of that wrapper yet?
Are you still hearing it?
Yeah.
I switched headphones.
Well, are you done eating that motherfucker? Or? Sounds pretty crunchy.
Some tartar sauce in there. A little bit of leftover cheese.
Hey, Kira, have you ever had a filet-o-fish?
Maybe once. I don't remember.
mic, have you?
Oh, yeah.
I don't think I ever have.
I've had one. Back in high school, I remember having one.
I've just never, like, anytime I've gone to McDonald's in the last 30 years, it's I've just been like, well, I gotta get a burger, you know. I mean, I know it's ridiculous, because, but I'm one of those people, it's like, oh, I'm at a, you know, whatever type of restaurant it is, I've got to get whatever their main thing is, you know, like Arby's fish sandwich. I'm like, why the fuck would I come here and get a fish sandwich, you know?
Yeah.
But, you know, maybe it's great.
Or you can go to Arby's and get their burger.
Yes, and you know what's funny about that? And apologies if I've said this on the show before, but
I've had enough of eating burgers.
Yeah, that was their whole fucking ad campaign back in the day. In fact, we went to an Arby's when I was a kid, and it was like a traumatizing experience, because we were like at the counter ordering, and my parents were like, what do you want? And I was like, a bacon cheeseburger. And like the employees, and you know, the guy at the counter, who I still remember what he looked like to this day, you know, like a fat guy with a mustache, he just like burst out into laughter, and like all the employees, like they just heard the dumbest thing they heard in their entire life. Because at the time, you know, their whole thing was like anti-burger. It was like, we don't have bacon cheeseburgers. I just felt like a big piece of fucking shit. And here they are now.
Yeah.
You know, just 40 years later.
You know, they probably went on to tell that story so many times about the kid that came in and tried to order a burger. And how stupid he was.
It's like I was talking about earlier. It's just, you know, evolution. These companies, like, get bought out by other companies, and then they're just not what they once were. You know? Just, it's everything just morphs into something else. Let's make a Pran Funkel.
What is this?
Hey!
What is this?
Hey!
That's my pie.
I don't know if you could hear that, but that's the steak burgers guy. He's saying it's a song about steak burgers.
What is this?
Hey!
What is this?
Hey!
And what's the dominant sound we're hearing there?
Clip. Some old school wrestler that made an album. Like, about probably a wrestler food? From the 50s or 60s.
Steak burgers!
So are we gonna call the steak burger guy?
If I have his number.
Oh, I have it. I know.
I do have it.
If they're still in business, I know where it is.
Could you play that again?
Mike, could you play? We haven't heard any of the clips from Pran Funkels in a long time.
Could you play that again for me? Could you play that again for me?
Play that triangle again, Ed Grimley.
What is this?
Hey!
What is this?
Hey!
What is this?
They may Might be out of business.
A while ago, you told me your name was Jim Rockford.
I think that was Maxine.
I think it's a different lady.
Mike probably doesn't even know who Maxine Headroom is right now.
He's been Maxine? Gone. It's been gone a long time.
I'm sure you were involved in some calls to this lady, but she's very southern sounding. Like southern lunch lady sounding. It might have been that lady that you were displaying. She's just like on almost every order line that we call.
Anti-Gendelson-Pest.
Let's call your 11th favorite friend.
Please leave your message for
Mike Van Heusen.
It's not no ma'am.
I was trying to find a commercial that I saw a million times as a kid, and of course, you know, frustratingly, it's not on YouTube, I guess. Super ghouls as well as ghosts.
Please leave your message for
Mike Van Heusen.
No, I'm sorry, ma'am. I didn't give you my number.
Nothing has been recorded. Record your message after the tone. Simply hang up when done. Or for delivery options, press the pound sign.
Am I gay? There are three men on the hood of my Honda Accord. Am I gay? Dumb motherfucker.
Miss Mush, you mushing fruit slush, doing the fruit slush mush. Just Miss Mush, eating fruit slush, doing the fruit slush mush.
New Wyler's fruit slush, the mushy fruit slush.
Your message. Press 1.
All right,
to
Caleb,
continue recording,
you've got a
press
cot,
2.
You can come
to
lay
delete
on.
And re-record your message, press 3.
All right, Caleb, you did a good job on that commercial.
Three men on the hood of my Honda Accord. Am I gay? Dumb motherfucker.
Miss Mush, you mushing fruit slush, doing the fruit slush mush. Just Miss Mush, eating fruit slush, doing the fruit slush mush. New Wyler's fruit.
To replay your message, press 1. To continue.
Yeah, what did I say that guy's name was?
I don't know.
Just a minute ago.
I forget.
Someone in the, anyone in the audience paying attention?
But I played that like really early days of Pran Funkels, and then like years later, you brought out the Wyler's one. I didn't know about that, and then now like 10 years into it,
yeah,
we play that, and it says Wyler's.
That's a you know. There's no fucking denying that's the same singer. Well, Randy. His name's probably Randy.
Yeah.
Can we get it? We've got a cot over here. Can we just lay him down on it? All right, Randy, calm down. We're done recording songs for a minute.
I put cocaine in his fruit slush.
You know, hey, Randy, we stopped the world. Now let's not let your world stop.
Yeah. Randy, I think you need some CPR right now.
Randy, take a bite of this orange. Hey, man, this is the good tent that you've entered, Randy. For the first time in your life, you've entered something good. Hey, want to see some pudding?
Please stand by for a Pran Funkels public service announcement.
Do you think you know what scouting's all about? Take a look.
Be prepared.
Are you ready to get involved?
Be prepared.
Are you ready to take the lead?
Scouting today is a lot more than you think. Join your local troop.
Prepare for Operation Starblade. Calling Star...
This has been a Pran Funkels public service announcement.
Well, fuck yourself.
Wow, that brings back memories.
I think we also found the announcer for the... from Namco for the Geosword operation.
Be prepared for Geosword.
Yeah, can we compare that? What we just heard?
Announcement.
Oops. Yeah.
It's very relaxing.
Be prepared. Are you ready to get involved?
Be prepared.
Are you ready to take the lead?
Scouting today is a lot more than you think. Join your local troop.
On Geosword. Come in. Geosword. The enemy a task forced mechanized planet Red Eye.
Same guy, right?
It says prepare, be prepared, and then doesn't he say prepare for something?
Just reached the Federation of Planets and is approaching our mother planet. Our strategy is to neutralize Red Eye and defeat the menace to our mother planet.
I think we've established this on the show, but neutralizing Red Eye equals putting people to sleep. With your just the tone of your voice.
Yeah.
Which is what we do on Pran Funkels, right?
It's like, what mission are we on? I fell asleep. Let's... let's call a...
Like that.
Sorry, I was hoping there was some voiceover on that.
Hello. Thank you for calling Meaningful Beauty. If you are a new customer and would like to place your first order, please press 1. If you would like, your call will be recorded for quality assurance purposes.
Thank you for contacting Meaningful Beauty. We value your time, and an agent will be with you shortly. Did you know you can order right now on our website? Visit MeaningfulBeauty.com to purchase special TV offers through our fast, convenient, and secure online experience. Founded by Cindy Crawford and developed by world-renowned aesthetic specialist, Dr. Jean-Louis Sabah, Meaningful Beauty offers the latest in skincare and hair care science, designed to make you look and feel your best. We appreciate your patience. Please continue to hold.
disappointment. They should be impressed by that and not hang up. It's fucking cocksuckers.
Hello. Thank you for calling Meaningful Beauty. If you are, your call will be recorded for quality assurance purposes.
Starting to question.
Thank you for contacting Meaningful Beauty.
What is
we value beauty? Your time and an agent will be with you shortly.
Means something.
Did you know you can order right now on our website? Visit meaningfulbeauty.com to purchase special TV offers through our fast, convenient, and secure online experience.
And does your website hang up on us as well?
Fuck it.
Founded by Cindy Crawford and developed by world-renowned aesthetic specialist, Dr. Jean-Louis Sabat, Meaningful Beauty offers the latest in skincare and hair care science, designed to make you look and feel your best. We appreciate your patience. Please continue to hold.
Taking the poor baby asleep.
Right, right.
I think we should call some other people, but keep calling them also at the same time.
Bitches.
Kira. If you want, I can keep calling them.
Hello.
We'll just continue.
Thank you
with
for
the
calling
show.
Me. Your call will be recorded for quality assurance purposes.
Thank you for contacting Meaningful Beauty. We value your time and an agent will be with you shortly. Did you know you can order right now
Beauty
on our website?
Answering the
Visit
phone.
meaningfulbeauty.com to purchase special TV offers through our fast, convenient, and
Speaking
secure
to
online
human
experience.
Beings, like, they're on the same level as you.
Founded by Cindy Crawford and developed by world-renowned aesthetic specialist, Dr. Jean-Louis Sabat, Meaningful Beauty offers the latest in skincare and hair care science, designed to make you look and feel your best. We appreciate your patience. Please continue to hold.
Mom, Dad, someday I want to grow up to be an aesthetic care specialist.
Running to Granny's.
Yes, I want to do that too.
I think they're just listening to all the...
They're trolling us, yeah.
Yeah.
Alright, I mean, do you want me to shut the fuck up and try it, or...
Nah, let's just call the Marble Muncher.
Marble's got marble
Your call has been forwarded to an automated voice messaging system.
Alright.
8.
Sorry to wake you up. Your call is very far.
Your call.
Alright. That was like they hired her to say that. She was like, you know what? I'm gonna do something different. We've been hearing that same operator bitch for 50 years. I'm gonna have some a little bit of emotion in it. Your call has been forwarded to... How are we doing? Oh yeah. A voicemail thing.
Apple hair?
Mmm, that sounds tasty.
Let's call a business.
Don't wait.
Hi, and thank you for calling to order alien tape. For quality purposes, this call will be
alien
recorded.
Me.
I didn't get that. If you'd like to place
alien
an order,
me,
say...
Bitch.
Sorry, I still didn't get that. A live customer service representative will be with you shortly.
The best thing is for Bertha not to talk. This is what Bertha sounds like tonight. apparently Bertha's not going to die.
I think it's called Aiden Tate. This call may be recorded. Your first name?
Josephs.
Hello.
Joseph?
Hello?
We knocked that one out of the park.
Hi, and thank you for calling to order Alien Tape. This call will be recorded.
Y'all.
Okay.
Good.
As you saw on TV, a roll of Alien Tape.
I want a roll of aliens, man.
Ma'am?
Hi, and thank you for calling to order Alien Tape. For
ma'am.
Quality purposes, this call will be recorded.
You want ma'am?
A live customer service representative will be with you shortly.
Excuse me? Ma'am?
Hello, thanks for calling. All customer service representatives are busy at the moment. A live customer service representative will be with you shortly.
I'm sorry. Can you hear me? Are you still there?
I'm sorry. All customer service representatives are busy at the moment. A live customer service representative will be with you shortly.
Can you hear me? Hello?
I'm sorry. All customer service representatives are busy at the moment. A live customer service representative will be with you shortly. We apologize for the wait. We value your business, and we'll be with you as quickly as possible.
Scooter's nut. It's going Bina Buns.
No.
Hey, the quicker you accept it, the quicker you can move on with your life.
Ma'am.
For quality purposes, call may be recorded. To ensure proper handling and quality assurance, this call will be recorded. May I continue?
Ma'am. Can you hear me?
May I continue?
Are you still there?
I'm right here.
Okay. Strange.
Okay. Would you like to place an order today?
Do you know Karen? Ma'am?
Yes, I'd like to order 5,000.
Wow.
That's one of those products you have to be... it's very sought after. You have to be on your tippy toes. Do you want to buy our product? Well, fuck you. Yeah. You better be on the ball, bitch. Alright.
And now for another Pran Funkels Random Clip.
Yeah.
fit. I know that how I look, what I weigh, and how I feel are entirely up to me, and I do everything I need to do each day and each moment to create the me I really choose to be. I have self-belief and self-control. I'm in control.
That guy is not in control.
Stomper SSC Supercycle Daredevil Loop Set from Shopper. Assembly required.
If you're going through with this, may I suggest you permit me to activate the turbo boost? Allow me to demonstrate.
Hey, watch out. Uh-oh. Now what? Yow. Yow! Oh, great.
I'm here at Paul Masson Chateau in California. Almost every night here, there's a wine-tasting party. I'm here at Paul Masson.
Wilford Brimley for new Quaker Toasted Oatmeal.
Are we out of oatmeal around here?
It's right there.
Where?
Under your nose.
It's our other oatmeal.
Uh-huh.
Come on,
well,
I need my fix.
In this house, there is no other oatmeal. Just Quaker. Toasted oatmeal? Come on, that's not hot oatmeal.
Nope, it's cold. But it's oatmeal. You see there? Real Quaker oatmeal right on the flakes.
Kind of noisy, ain't it?
New Quaker Toasted Oatmeal. Original or honey nut?
It's my other oatmeal.
Kind of noisy, ain't it? Especially when it's plopping out of you later.
Ew. Oh, Mike had to go.
Oh, shit.
He conked out.
Well, I'm glad he was on.
Yeah. It's been a really long time.
And we got a lot of people in the chat.
What's that?
Well, we've got some people in the chat. Should I mention them real quick?
Yeah, you want to thank the patrons?
Yeah. But first, let's make a definite distinction between the two.
Okay.
Mr. Donathan Wongathan is in the chat, or was at some point, that Google will not let me know how long ago that was.
Can you click on the side of it? Does it say timestamp?
When I click on the three dots, it's gonna get really people on my computer.
Alright, the three, where do I click?
Let me take a look.
Hump, take a look at my good friend Humpernickel, Humpernickel, Humpernickel. Pom, pom, boom, take
okay.
A Humpernickel.
To the right of live chat, there are three dots.
I clicked on live chat.
And then
click on participants.
timestamps.
Oh, I don't think...
Okay. Oh, so you have to turn it on? Oh, that's fucking stupid. Why is that not on by default?
I don't know.
Once again, just like with Zoom and original sound, why the fuck is that not turned on by default?
Maybe they figure some people just think it clutters things up and they don't care what time it came in.
Well, the Zoom thing I almost get because it's like, you know, they're in cahoots with ISPs and like, let's try to, you know, let them use as little bandwidth as possible or whatever.
Right.
But what difference does it fucking make? Why wouldn't you want to see the times of the comments on your YouTube feed?
It's probably personal preference.
Well, Blue Hot 123, Angry Music Man, Rock and Rolla 369, Colin.
Hi, fellas.
Was that Joffrey?
Mm-hmm.
Theodore Pentagram from the Chipmunks or something? Had a lot to say. And Mr. KBBB7. And should we thank the patrons real quick?
KBBB7!
Yes.
Is that from a Jorge Lucas joint?
It's a combination of the Fat Boys and the Elder Scrolls video game series.
So it is like a RPG kind of thing.
Yes, it is.
I can detect that, you know.
Like the no-go guy?
Yes.
It's the voice of the guard, so if you do something bad, then that guy scolds you or tries to kill you or arrest you.
He says KBBB7.
Well, it was back when the website Uber Duck was really cool because you could make your own voices. And they had all these voices, including that one.
Oh, look, a letter.
What?
Sorry. A thing started playing when I didn't want it to.
Okay.
Sorry about that. I'm gonna mute that account.
Okay.
Okay. Continue.
Uber Duck was a website that.
Uber Duck.
Yeah. Where you could create like text-to-speech out of basically anything, and it had all these sounds like for the longest time. And then one day, it's like they were all gone. So my guess is like they got hit with copyright stuff. So. But yeah, you used to be able to type out something for the guard from Elder Scrolls to say, but not anymore. So,
what was I looking up? Oh. The patrons? Alright, I'll be right back.
I have a Patreon, and it's, like, pretty hard to see who the patrons are, so. It's very confusing. Let's call. Unless you're ready for the patrons. It's called the Buffalo Rider. Maybe he wants to talk to Indiana Jones.
Thank you.
Leave a message after the beep.
Hey, fuck you. Leave a message after the beep.
I think we established that's possibly the rudest voicemail ever. She's
not even rapping it.
What's that?
Not even rapping, just being rude.
Yeah. She's like disgusted with you. Like, let's hear that again.
What, are you too old to text? Well then.
Leave a message after the beep.
Hey. Aha. In a perfect world, that would do the job. Ring for the master. Take it easy, big fella. Marduk used this thing to charge up his thunderbolts. You don't happen to have any socialist vodka on hand.
Ready, Mr. Rock and Roll, that's wacky, wild, Kool-Aid style.
Of course, you could edit that into a hellacious recording. They're like, wow, wow. Are you there, Kira?
Yeah, that's a little too much for me, that commercial.
I would agree with that, verily.
Like, I can only take so much excitement with all that stuff you're throwing at me there.
First of all, the chew, in and of itself, I'd be okay with. But all that chocolate with it? Eh.
Kind of drags it down. Too bulky.
Little Michael is not performing his duties, so.
How can I ever forget one of my special customers, Little Michael? Every week he'd come.
Can I suggest that gets played in a call?
Yes, I agree. Let's call this. Or I'll do this one.
Please hold while we connect your call.
This call may be recorded for quality assurance.
Thank you for calling Jacuzzi Bathroom Model. My name is Kayla, and how may I direct your call?
Yes, I was interested in the jacuzzi.
Okay, are you looking to set up an appointment?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I can definitely help you out with that. I do just have to go over a couple quick questions to make sure we can help you out. Can I please get your first and last name?
Ileana Sulikowski.
Can you please spell that for me?
Ileana Sulikowski. K-O-W-S-K-I.
Great, and just in case we get cut off, may I have the number you are calling from?
It is 402. What is the noise on telephone?
I have no idea, honestly. That's what I was just about to ask because I couldn't hear anything you were just saying.
What is the Ryanbear?
I'm not too sure what that noise was. I couldn't hear anything you were saying.
Well, what was it? Is on your telephone?
No. That wouldn't have been from my end because I'm on a business line and I've never heard that noise before.
What did it say, Ryanbear?
I'm sorry, what was that?
What were the people saying? They were hooting and hollering.
I'm honestly not sure. I'm not near anybody. I'm in a remote position, so I'm not near anybody that could have been yelling on the phone.
Well, it sounded like you had the office party.
No, I'm in a remote position. I'm not around anybody. I'm actually work from home. I thought it was coming from your end on a TV.
Oh, okay. Do you work from home after the COVID?
I work from home. I'm in a remote position. Anyway, can I please get the number you are calling from, just in case we get cut off?
Oh, it's 402-882-2083.
Great. And then, is that your home phone, your work phone, your cell phone?
It is a cell phone. Are you okay? Do you have the COVID?
No, I just have a cold. And then what is your zip code to make sure that we service your area?
You said you are in what remote position? You are at home?
Correct. And then what is your zip code so I can verify that we do service your area so I can help set up this appointment?
May I place you on brief hold? I need to get a piece of mail.
Okay.
Thank you.
Well, Alan Thicke made her hang up. The end theme recorded across the room from the television set of Different Strokes.
Yeah. She's like, somebody recorded that on their phone. I'm hanging up. That's not the official Different Strokes.
At least prank call me with a 16-bit, 48 kilohertz, 320 kilobytes per second recording.
Yeah.
What might be right for some... might be wrong for gumming into your gonadoop.
A possible useful doohickey.
That perfectly describes Pran Funkels, I think. That's the name of... Alright, Cody. Make a note. That's the title. I've been keeping track of wacky titles of each episode. If there is one. For quite a while. And that's tonight's. What was it?
A possible useful doohickey.
That's it, yeah. George Lucas is gonna sue us for having that being the title of something, but let's not forget Han Solo shot first.
Nope.
Turbo.
Whoa!
Okay,
Let's make a Pran Funkel.
Yeah.
How you doing, Kirit? Are you high?
Yeah, are you?
Do I sound like I am?
Yes.
Good. At least I have my bearings.
Yes. Let's call the inventor of Mexican jumping beans.
Text now subscriber you are trying to reach is not available. Please leave your message after the tone.
It's not available.
The text now subscriber you are trying to reach is not available. Please leave your message after the tone.
There's a gag battle going on in your throat, hon. I hope you don't have too much homemade cake filling it up. Alright, good night, hon.
You without me be like cornflake without the milk.
Sounds like you're a crumb cake individual. You crumb cake.
I'll be damned. It opened. It's
not even homemade cake.
Now what? It's
not even apple hack.
I don't do miracles or anything fancy, kid.
Thank you.
I don't need a man to tell me that a man should smell like a man. Thank you. I'm Jackie Palance.
I don't need some fancy cologne to tell me I'm a man. I use Skin Bracer. It smells great. But it also cools and tones my skin. Confidence is very sexy. Don't you think?
Original and cooling blue. By Menon.
Can you play the beginning of that again?
I don't need some fancy cologne to tell me I'm a man. I use Skin Bracer. It smells great.
Skin, brace yourself for about what's about to happen. You're about to find out if you're a man. Well, no one asked for this. Certainly, sir. Ready to throw myself on this grenade.
You're right, like nobody ever wants that. Nobody asks for it. It's like you hear this. Like not one person wants to hear that, probably.
Well, there's one person. You know who it is?
Teacher Lady.
I don't know, but whoever it is should do the next call.
Okay.
Your dealer's choice on the number. And my dealer is really good at supplying my crack to me. Kira. Nice. Let the record show.
Thank
that
you for
Kira
calling ActiStyle.
Provided this crack.
This call will be recorded for quality and training purposes. Please press 0 to speak to an associate. Please stay on the line. There
Please
will be a
press
brief period
what
of
you
silence
think of yourself
while you were being transferred.
Assurance purposes, this call may be monitored or recorded.
Thank you for calling ActiStyle.
Mm-hmm.
Hello, my name is Chris. I see you're calling about ActiStyle's incontinence supply program. Is this the first
yes
time you've ever called ActiStyle?
Yes.
Thank you, and are you calling about supplies for yourself or someone else?
Myself.
Thank you. I'd be happy to get some information and see if you qualify. May I have your first name, please?
Robert.
Thank you. And your last name, please, sir?
Feldermorens.
How do you spell that, please?
Feldermorans.
Thank you. So Robert Feldermorens.
Oh, you left out an I somewhere. No.
Okay. What did what did I leave out where?
In the Feldermorens part. There was an I before that N, and then that S.
So
let's not get caught in the weeds. What was the product?
ActiStyle incontinence supplies?
Yes.
Okay, what is your home address, please, sir?
What? 423 Wonder Lane.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
What's the rest of the address, please?
Beg your pardon?
What's the rest of your address? The city, state, and zip code.
I thought it was a local company I was talking to.
No, we're in Minnesota.
Okay. Well, I just wanted to order the stuff.
I understand. I'm looking to see if you qualify, but I need your zip code.
21784.
And which city is that, please?
Quincy Jones.
Sorry, what city was that?
Quincy Jones University.
Okay. No, not... What city is it?
Los Angeles, California.
Okay, what was your zip code again, please?
Kelly Savalas.
Sir, what was your zip code again, please?
What was your zip code? I don't trust you. My son keeps telling me that scammers are trying to
Okay, well, I can't see if
people.
You qualify if you won't give me the required information, sir.
I can't see. My son's telling me that we're getting ripped off by scammers.
Okay, well, that's up to you whether you want to leave the information or not, but I can't help you if you won't give me the required information.
What company are you representing?
ActiStyle.
Larry
doesn't believe
you. We have diapers, briefs, and pads.
Larry doesn't believe you.
What? Okay, well, you can either give me the required information or disconnect. I can't help you if you won't give me the information I need.
Can I place you on a brief hold? Hang on a second.
For 1 minute.
Hello?
Yes?
Hi, Sean Gildermans.
How can I help
at
you?
At Remington Park.
How can I help you?
I'd like to order that thing.
I'd be happy to get some information then and see if you qualify.
I qualify for everything.
Again, I'd be happy to get some information and see if you qualify.
I know I qualify.
Okay, again, I'd be happy to get some information and see if you qualify. What was your first name again?
Sean.
S-E-A-N?
Yes.
Thank you. And what is your last name, please?
Gildermans.
How do you spell that, please?
Gildermans.
G-U-I-L-D-E-R-M-A-N-S.
I'll swap out that U for an I, and yes.
Thank you. And what is your home address, please?
$423 Wonder Lane.
Okay, and your zip code, please.
's where it gets complicated.
I don't know how zip code can be complicated.
Well, let me tell you.
It's a zip code for your
digit,
physical address.
Yeah, each digit, there's 5 digits. Each one represents a different part of this great country of ours. And it can be very complicated to know. Off the top of
okay,
one person's
I
head.
I don't need an explanation.
The zip
I don't need an explanation. I just need your zip code.
I believe you asked for an explanation.
No, I did not ask for an explanation. I just need your zip code.
I think you did. Okay, I'm sorry.
If
let
you
me
do
let
not
talk
provide
your
zip code, I will disconnect.
All right, my husband's going to give it to you. Hang on.
23, 19, 4.
What was that zip code again, please?
23, 19, 4, 1.
That's too many digits. What was the zip code again, or I will disconnect?
23, 19, 4.
Turn off the recording, or I'm going to disconnect.
I'm working on it.
Ileana. Can you speak with this lady?
I just need your zip code, or I will disconnect.
It is 92111.
Disconnecting called you to prank call.
It's at... Oh,
God damn, that lady was such a bitch.
God damn it.
Well, I gotta go. Unless you wanna keep...
I can't do this by myself.
Okay.
Did we thank the patrons?
No.
Do we have time to, or...
Yeah, I gotta go after that, though.
Okay. Love you a lot, patrons. Oh, here we go. I think I got it. Thanks for listening.
Are you thanking the patrons?
Yes. I'm loading it right now.
Let's just wait till next time.
Nah, okay. Well, angry music then?
I love you.
Mr. Donathan Wongathan.
God bless your soul.
Give me just a second here.
Let's just end it. I gotta go.
As thank the patrons.
Okay, what are the rest of the patrons? Okay.
Just a second. I got it here. Okay. You ready?
Yes. Alright, no, I gotta go.
Oh, wait, hang on.
Love you a lot.
I'm playing the music here. I think I need to unmute. Yeah. Alright, sorry. Angry music, man.
I'm a man at peace.
Colin? Woo.
I want to talk to a man.
Blue what? 1, 2, 3.
The Gladstone.
Redacted.
I'm really happy.
Jimmy.
I'm very happy.
Donathan Wongathan.
I can help you.
Chrisington J. Wimberly.
God bless you, baby.
Love you that. And last but not least, the man in the fleece, KBB7.
I love you.
Love you a lot. Good night. Thanks for hanging out.
I want to fancy a...
Inks. Long after you put quiet, I register stinks. Inks. Long after you put quiet, I register stinks. Inks. Long after you put quiet, I register stinks.